as lágrimas.
Good to see you back on the field, brah.
Yeah, it's been a minute. It's good to be on the field and yeah, just looking forward for the season.
Hey. Yo,
Not even.
It's the life of
how often do you train,
Joe?
How often do you train?
Training is pretty much 4 times a week, but gym-wise, I'm not really a fan of the gym.
Oh yeah, because so, training fan on the gym, you're fan.
Yeah, you're pretty much on your feet most of the time. So yeah. I work a lot, mostly on my explosive work and...
Explosive work?
Yeah.
What is explosive work?
No. Basically, I don't really do a lot of weight, so I just do body weight stuff.
Oh, body weight. So I'm shower shorter.
Young Howard Mnisi, where were you born and what was it like for you growing up?
So I was born in a little town in Mpumalanga, Elukwatini.
Elukwatini.
A lot of people.
Really?
A lot of people think I'm from the
second.
No. Tina, we more simmered down a little bit because obviously we don't speak Swati. Grew up in a very big family unit. Had a lot of love. They always, you know, supported me in terms of my sport, so hence I'm here.
Why did you move so far for your rugby?
Initially, I was at the Sharks, right? And obviously, everyone as a youngster, you think you're going to be a superstar at like 19, 20, 21. But I always like had a thing with my mom where I said, if I don't make it at 22, then I'm definitely going to go study. So I had an opportunity to come to Tux, but I knew because of the systems there, I wasn't going to be able to, you know, to get my degree. So
the bonafide systems.
Yeah, but also because I don't want to bash universities, but some.
But they're bonafide.
You can't get to go to classes.
Tux is bonafide.
That's what he's saying. You don't get to go to class because you're always training.
Because you're always training and stuff. They're more rugby focused because they were one unit with the Bulls Union. Mm. So I decided let me go to NMMU and actually get my degree. When I got there, the coach kind of like insisted that I recruit some guys from Durban that were not playing, and we actually ended up creating a very decent team, and we went all the way to the semis in the Varsity Cup, and you know, I got spotted again. Well, and I wasn't really there for rugby at the end of the day, but you know, it's funny how life works out, and then I got spotted by the Cheetahs, and then my journey just kept on.
So Kunewenza nagayodlala NMMU, does that mean also bofunda nakhona?
Yeah, study.
Mm. Oh, okay. Yeah. So is that what happens in South Africa now?
Yeah.
But that's the power,
like in America.
Basically, to get for me,
like what they do in America with basketball.
Yeah, yep. I always used rugby. I always used sport to try and get myself a degree, right?
Mm.
Because my parents couldn't afford to take me to varsity, so that was always like my goal. Like use this tool, because I always believed in being an all-rounded human being. Like you can be a sportsman, you can have a career, but it always gets to a point where it has to end, and you have to start a life, you know, beyond that. So I'm still adamant about that. Haven't really finished, but I'm still working on it, which is it's gonna take a while.
Tell us a bit about those explosive movements. Why is it so important as a center to be able to get off the mark quickly?
I think because you're a link, most of the times, you know, you have to find mismatches. You have to gauge where the position is and be able to take advantage of those mismatches, being able to put guys through into the gaps, and whenever the opportunity arises, you break the line, you have to be able to go and score. So I think it's very important to be very explosive, and as well as your eyes and your vision in terms of spotting the gaps, spotting opportunities, has to be really on a high level, especially at Super Rugby level.